Hi traders, I have a short lesson for you. It's called retest. We're going to understand what retest is all about. As you can see here, this is CMCM. I took CMCM long today, right here, at that point, as it pulled back from the highs. Now, that trade wasn't a large quantity trade. It was just 600 shares, as you can see here, CMCM. And I bought it at 17:10, and the time was 3 minutes past 10. So I took CMCM as it after it moved to a new high and pulled back. The pullback point is called a retest. The retest point is what I want to discuss right now. So what is a retest? Why did I go long CMCM? And yes, it worked out fine. CMCM, as you can see, end result was a $200 winner for me. I had a fine day today with several winners, just one loser, as you can see here in Kodak. Finished my day up a little bit more than $3,000. And let's go back to CMCM, and I want to explain the idea of a pullback and a retest. So when the stock is moving to a new high and I missed the new high, you should be buying it. The reversal point right here in CMCM was the point where you should go long. So as you can see, CMCM moved to new highs, triggered here. I didn't see that happening. I did not go long CMCM as it moved here to a new high. I was watching it a little bit later. Now that stock was posted today in my trading room by one or in fact few of my traders. They noticed that the stock is up right now. As you can see here, it's up by 14%. So everybody's watching CMCM. You need also to take a look at the daily. Daily looks like it's coming up with a huge momentum. Yesterday was a breakout point. That was the bull flag formation here where it broke up to new highs. And today was the momentum day. So the momentum day is also very important. Everybody was watching it yesterday. A lot of people were watching it today. Stock is up more than 14% today. So it looked lovely. A lot of people are following it, looking for reversals, new highs, technical formation. And they bought it once it moved here to a little bit over 17. So I missed that point and I never chase stocks up. So CMCM did move higher. I missed that trade, therefore I was waiting it for to come down. The point where it comes down to the entry point was the point which we call a retest. That's the retest point. Now, what's a retest point? A retest point is the point where everybody is only interested in buying, meaning the stock moved up to a new high, then pulled back down. At that point where it comes back to the breakout point, that's it here, the breakout point, that's the point where everybody wants to buy. Now, who is everybody? Well, there's three different groups. Group number one are the people who are interested in going long just like I do and missed it. So group number one saw the stock moving to a new high, was very, very sorry that they did not participate in that trade, waited for it to come down because they do not chase stock higher just like I do. Just think about that. You needed to buy it here. You saw it moving higher. You didn't want to buy it at 17.50 because it moved all the way up to 17.50 right over there. So you waited for it to come down, and if it would come down, not necessarily it would, but if it would come down, then well, it just came down to the point where I missed it earlier. I love that trade. I love the daily. I love the intraday formation. Yes, I should buy one. That's group number one. Group number two is the people who actually joined the trade, the one who bought here. And you may think, fine, these guys bought here at 17, stock moved up to 17.50, should they be happy? Well, theoretically speaking, if you're thinking about it, yeah, well, they should be happy, but no. Well, one thing I want to talk, when I'm talking about traders, we're never happy. Nobody's really happy in trading. The only thing that comes to your mind is, well, I bought it at 17. In fact, I should have bought much more than 400 shares. I watched the stock going higher. I watched the daily. The daily looks perfect. I watched it moving at a nice reversal, moving to a new high. Why did I only buy 400 shares? And now it's at 17.50 and you will never buy some more because it's too expensive now. But You're very sorry you didn't buy more. You're very sad that you didn't get more at the breakout point. And now that it comes back down, you're thinking, well, I just bought 400 shares. That's the point where I'm willing to buy some more. So that's the second group, the group that are very, very sorry they didn't buy more at the first place. So they're buying some more. That's the second group. The third group are the short sellers. The short sellers, excuse me for saying, are the idiots who short a stock that is moving higher by 14% and think they can make some money as it pulls back. Look at this lovely topping tail here. Now they think surely it should come down and they're shorting it. So they're the one who's shorting it at around 17 here, thinking it's probably going to come down. Well, sometimes they're right, most of the time they're wrong. And at that time, it just moved to a new high. Now, do they move out? Yes, if they are professional traders, but 90% of them are not professional traders. Therefore, they look for the stock moving up to a new high, and now they're very, very sad they took the short trade. And since it's at 1750, they will never close it because now they lose, they're losing too much. So it's a big, huge loser now. And the only thing that they do now is pray for it. Please, please, please calm down. Sometimes it does, sometimes it doesn't. At this case, it did. So when it does come down to the area of 17, they will move out of a losing short trade. They just realized they did a big mistake. So they are moving out of this losing short trade. And what does a trader who's shorting does when he's closing a short trade, a losing short trade, or any short trade? They're buying. So closing a short trade means buying. So they're buying here. That's the third group. All of the three, the ones, again, I'm repeating, all of the three groups are groups who are buying at the retest point. They are the ones who missed the trade like I do and bought at the retest. They are the ones who bought it and think that they didn't buy enough, so they're waiting for it to come down and they're buying. And they're the third group, the short sellers who are buying and closing losing trade. So all three groups are buying. That's why we call it a retest. It retests the breakout point. That's a technical formation. When you have resistance and you go through resistance and then you come down, the resistance now becomes a support. I just explained why a resistance, a former resistance, become a support. So you can just, you know the basics of technical analysis, and the basics says that when you have a resistance, now it becomes a support. Sure, you know it. And I don't think I mentioned something new to those of you who know about technical analysis, but now you know why. The reason you have a retest, the reason why you a former resistance becomes support is because it's called a retest, because there's these three groups that I just mentioned here, and they are all buyers. So just think about that. Next time you take a trade, you don't necessarily have to buy it as the stock is moving to a new high. If you miss the trade, you can join at the retest. Now, the reason I bought only 600 shares and not my regular size is because buying at the retest is a little bit more risky, although this trade worked out fine, but it's a bit more risky. So when you buy at the retest, make sure that you buy smaller size. Take a little less risk. Well, I do hope this lesson was good for you. Thank you very much for watching. And see you in my trading room, or just click here on the top right side of the screen to join my free 14-day trial in the trading room. And please don't forget, we still have this January kickoff promotion, 10% off of all of our programs, where you can get all of our programs for a 10% discount. This intro program, for example, is sold for $450. You can save $50 if you buy it right now for the next 2 days. And it comes with education, it comes with a funded $14,000 account, it comes with everything you need in order to start, become a trader, and join us in the main trading room and trade live with us. Thank you very much for watching, and see you in the next lesson. Bye, traders.
Thank you for watching my video. Do you have what it takes to become a trader? I would like to invite you to take my free trading challenge. If you succeed, I will fund you. You will get free access to a $14,000 trading account, which you can trade from home and earn 70% of the profits you generate. No risk, no cost. Just click here and join now. If you like this video, please subscribe to my channel here. If you have any questions, please use the comments below.